In order to texture in Quixel Mixer, first we need to bake a few maps in Blender. Open the high poly model and append the low poly one. In one of the previous tutorials, we set a material for the low poly lantern. Now we're going to bake some maps for it. Go to UV editing tab. We will use free text tools add-on for baking. Link for download is in the description. Select all of the meshes and go to baking. Let's test bake normal map with the default settings. It has baked normals of the first mesh only. Select force single and bake again. Now it has baked all of the normals from high poly. Let's increase texture size to 4K and bake again. Yellow colors means normals are inverted. To fix the yellow normals, we need to adjust the cage extrusion and ray distance. I came up with these numbers through trial and error. Let's bake once more. Perfect. Save the normal map. Now select curvature and bake. Save it. Next, we need to bake color ID map, but we'll bake diffuse map for this purpose. It asks for cycles. Enable cycles render engine and GPU compute. If it is grayed out, go to system and enable GPU hardware. Let's bake. Let's increase anti-aliasing. This is needed to smooth out the holes. Bake and save the map. Last but not least is the ambient occlusion map. It is too grainy if you bake it with the default settings. So let's increase anti-aliasing and samples, then bake again. It will take a while depending on specs of your computer. After bake is done, save the AO map. Okay, we are done with the necessary maps. Let's start Quixel Mixer. Change type to custom model and load low poly FBX. Now let's edit materials. Set material type to transparent. Go to texture sets and set maps that we've baked in Blender. Normal map, ambient occlusion map, curvature and diffuse for material ID. Now let's go to layers tab and add a smart material. Add a material ID mask on top of the smart material. Press 8 to see which color corresponds to which part of the model. Press 1 to go back to PBR look. Check blue for lantern's frame, etc. It already looks cool. Let's try another smart material. For example, old varnished. You can change parameters of smart materials almost like in Substance Painter. Select the same blue color mask. Now let's choose a material for wires. For example, rusted. Select the red color mask. Let me disable displacement. Lastly, let's texture the glass. Add a solid layer. Reveal only glass by masking material ID. Let's make changes to albedo, metalness and roughness maps. Enable opacity map and load a simple gradient texture, which you can download from internet or make your own in an image editor. Final touch would be make the material double-sided. Sure, Substance Painter is much more capable texture editor, but if you want a free alternative, or perhaps you don't like big greedy corporations, you can try Quixel Mixer. See you in another tutorial.